here in Hanoi, northern Vietnam, and this is the Vietnam Museum of Ethnology. Okay, so within the front door of the museum here, coming in, and you have kind of circle situation with the dome at the top and a central pole right here. Interesting sort of architecture up here. It goes right up, bird figure up here that turns the pole. But this pole is basically a ritual pole, and within here you can see the reference to the universal tree, and it's a reference to the spirit world as well, to that central pillar within rituals, and central pillar going through the human body. So this is the ride up through here, but once again, similar to many other cultures, you can kind of see there is a sort of an aspect to it as well, an architectural aspect within here also, here within the museum. Vietnam has about 54 different ethnic groups, and sort of depiction up here of them, and a bit of a write up through here. 53, 54. So the iconic kind of bike right here, but within the display here, just looking, you can see reference to fairy right there, or immortal. And at display number two, so looking up here, and this is the depiction within the Vietnamese museum here of the fairy. Along with what would be an elemental there, perhaps also in the dragon. Interesting figure here with the look at the breasts hanging out. Interesting top, and top notch.
Duck keeper.
The duck keeper, yeah. The announcer right here. Beside the fairy, interestingly enough, has a kind of an apron configuration on. The triptych here, but also just interesting here with the two ladies offering. But if we look in, you can see the flowers now around the head, portal-like flowers around the head there. The flowers now around the head, portal-like flowers around the head there. Portal-like. The flowers now around the head, portal-like flowers around the head there. Different Vietnamese type wooden boats going through here. That central pillar right there, but up this way we have the two pillars right here. And these are pretty recent, but you have the flower of life type design in here. They're referred to as Eid House columns,
And you can read through here, relating to the owner's wealth and social position, so an embellishment to the house right there. Combination of flower petals and also elephants and rhinoceroses sort of combined with the pillars, so quite interesting in a way also. And a picture of the pillar in situ right there. You can see the blackness and soot within the house. And again, that design. Just interesting that there's the combination of animals with the pillar. Here's another shot with, in this case, yeah, you have the yin and yang type magic circle there with the equilibrium in the center, the central pillar, and very fitting. And then on the pillar going up, you see there's sort of four aspects to it around there. And going up, four aspects again. There's three aspects to the pillar also. Goes right up, right up, right up. You have the dome-like configuration up here. Dove type figure, in this case, or bird, and coming down here. And this figure in here. Another look. Now, this way we have a house through here. Just let the camera focus. And a stilt house, it's shortened, but within there's displays inside it. But within here, you can read that the stilt house of the black tie can be recognized by its distinctive turtle shell shaped roof, recounting the myth of a turtle that taught people how to build houses. So possibly looking at the potential of a spirit here, teaching people how to build. The Thai consider the turtle as their benefactor. So, and I'll just pan down here to get more of the description for the display here. Starting out with the description here of the ritual tree of the Thai. And going down through here, just a bit of a scroll down, mention to many animals and spiders, so forth. But so a ritual tree right here, yet again. And interestingly, they're kind of, in a way, the four around the one here also. Not unlike other trees and columns also. With mention here of protective spirits within this tree. Okay, so that is the tree there, that spirit type tree in a way. And coming through this way, you have the shaman's mask for rituals. Interesting, it's quite a freaky looking mask. Vietnamese shaman. And the description for it's right in here. Further within the museum here, just some of the, from all around Asia, with all those many, many different ethnic groups, you have the different dress. But in here, you have the different things. Well, it's not quite focusing, but you have the oboe. So the oboe right here, and then this quite remarkable drum, double-sided drum, and an old gun. We don't, an old rifle. We don't have the dates for this, but looking through the glass nonetheless, a crossbow here, the arrow. Within here. Within this display here, which is an initiation of Red Yao from Yinbai province. Among other things, lots of ritual equipment in here. Interestingly, crowns at the head, and then further behind here, the halo depictions also, with, in a way, the three figures, a kind of triptych configuration. Also within the artworks here, the further light within the artworks, the lotus petals. Within here from the hand, the lotus petals. And just coming back through here for a look, just for the some of the numerology in here, these numbers will come up, but within the writing here, and there's a lot to go through, but the number 3, the number 7, the number 12, and then further through here, 36, 72, and 120. So these figures coming through within the this ritual ceremony from one of the ethnic groups here within Vietnam. Within this paragraph, there would be so much to comment on. I'll just make a few comments. Obviously, you have sacred geometrical numbers within here, levels of initiation, ceremony lasting 3 days and three nights, mention within here of spiritual soldiers. Now, indeed, within Egypt and within Cambodia and places like that, you have depictions of battles and armies and so forth. And I've looked at this and looked at the cut-off heads and these sorts of things from Egypt and basically said to myself, look, this is not, you know, the showing of a physical battle. These are what I would suggest are interdimensional depictions. Also within here, you have what I would suggest are adherences by further interdimensional entities to these sacred geometric numbers, just as you would have adherences to dress, just as we do in the physical world as well. We saw the pillars of Jachin and Boaz, of course mentioned in the Bible, the house of the Lord, etc. And just look at the nature of the pillars compared with, say, the biblical pillars. Within this display here, these ornamental figures around, and this kind of noose here, this drum, the gongs. But so within the Vietnamese culture, you have the buffalo sacrifice of the Ba Na, and within here it basically talks about this sacrifice of the buffalo to the gods by the villagers. So from this ritual pillar here, we can walk through. There are many, many displays here, but this is a tomb right here. Just have a look at the description right here, which is faded a lot, but nonetheless, the tomb. Around it, you have the guardians at the corners in particular. Reference here to what would be male and female. Female energies, male and female, as you would see around the side, around the tree. So within here, it looks like you have that kind of, the energies in a way of the cherubim-like figures or human going into the center of the tree. The same up here also, so the energies into the center, perhaps, for sure. This ritual type situation. The star right near, the four-sided star. and in a way the four around the one depiction within here also. So it's this repeated symbolism. We can have a look on the other side here, and again yet another depiction of the two figures around the central tree, and again in a way shape-shifted with the birds right here. Some depictions of it on the wall here. Ceremonies here with the bulls, but also you have the shaman type figure in here with the mask through here within a ceremony. And here it is here, the Jirai funeral ceremony. And I'll just scroll down to get some of the information off here. The painting of it right here. Just standing around, and we'll go further through the museum. The depiction of the entities in a way sending the energies into that central pillar, which in itself could be a person, and you can possibly see a person within there also, but also just a sheer interdimensional pillar by itself perhaps too. But you see the architecture on there, sort of boat style there, and indeed you see these basic things in Egypt as well, with various energies and the boats and the architecture on the boats, the ark within the Bible, etc. Here you can see the mythical bird Garuda, and if we look at the depiction here, you can see the bird kind of emanating out the nature of the feathers that are almost kind of leaf-like. They look leafy, and the same here, it's like this emergence, gargoyle-esque emergence, if you were to compare this with other creatures kind of emerging, if you will, from the tree of life also. This part of the pole here is the spiritual tray, as noted there. And it's interesting within it, in a way, a reference to the four directions perhaps there, but also is an architectural nature to it. And you can see that it has the four-sided aspect to it, in this case with the bird spirits, in this case perhaps. We're now around behind the back of the museum. With the layout, you can see the in blue, so the river. This is the main museum here, with the serpent rolling through here, serpentine type river. Indeed, there is one at the Rookwood Cemetery in Sydney. Just coming out of that. Within here, just around the museum, just interestingly enough, you can see that is actually a piece of guttering right there, the bamboo, and then it would go into this one. So along here and then down here, quite intricate, and then down into this water catchment right here. So just the way, another use of bamboo by the Vietnamese people. Now we have this huge boat here, a canoe-like boat, Walker as it's called in New Zealand. And among other things, you have the foliage on it. And among other things, you have the foliage on it. Coming up this way, the foliage also. It's also like there's perhaps an emanation out of the foliage there also in a way. But nonetheless, that foliage goes right up. The interesting thing is that right up the end here, you have the eye right there. You have the eye right there. Now you can see this eye within Mozart's play, within the ship there. And you can also see it on, I think the film's The Burning Man. I'm not thinking of it right now, the name. But you can see the eye within a ship on that also.
So just thought I'd show that.
These videos take effort, so please donate with Dash Digital Cash rather than the digital cash from central banks. My donation address is below. Thank you. Now, we have this longhouse here, and there's another huge one up in the distance over here. The scale of this is huge. A replica, of course, but among other things, just to point out a few things, the sort of two pillars here in a way, and reference. Now these, quite frankly, look like breasts, four-sided star, the moon, stars right here, circles possibly a reference to the sun also. And as one would expect, in this case you have the elephants up here. So the elephants here, and the elephant over here. Kind of converging like cherubim into the center, if you will, the kind of a central pillar configuration. You can see the turtle involved in the pole right here, lizard right here, among other things. Many aspects, the sort of tree aspect in here also to the pillars, and that's a bit of a run through the center. So looking at this building once again there with these stairways here, the breasts again perhaps as well with the moon, so female and moon symbology here, it's really interesting. And just walking up onto here again, the two elephants up here sort of converging into the center. Again, that symbology and the symbolism here. So this is an Eid longhouse, 42.5 meters long. And of course it's showing here, so with the guy here with his laptop computer, but lots of historic things within here, animals up on the beams. Okay, so we'll now have a look at the Barna communal house. You can see the spirit type totem here, spirit tree pillar. Another kind of a configuration over here with the spirits. That would be represented protective spirits around the outside, and the walkways up here that of course could be taken down. So just walking up. And it would be shoes off to enter in here. Just taking a bit of a shot. Some colour in here with the four-sided star configurations and flower configurations up here. So just a bit of a look inside here. Just yet another look at some of the artistry within here, and have a little fireplaces up here within these constructions. Huge ceilings. Okay, Garai tomb, and just walking in here again, you can see reference to male and female. We'll have a further look at that also. So these would be the guardian spirits around the outside, and there's an animal within here also. The star type configurations within the drawings here, and once again male and female setups here. Male, there's the female, and male setups. And again here with the male and the female here, you can look inside. I don't know if the camera's going to adjust, but a brief look inside. Pregnant female in this case, and definitely much reference to the male and female anatomy through here, through this tomb. So reference here to the Kotu tomb house for wealthy people. Just scrolling down here through the text, and now you can see the gargoyle type configurations on this tomb house through the nose. Quite interestingly enough, these kind of cords or ropes, what would be perhaps a reference in here to cancer. If we look right in the center here, to cancer right there. So an astronomical thing with the, in a way, the kind of four around there, the four representing the four elements, no doubt. The two kind of dragons converging in the center around the kind of stupa there, the central pillar. The same would apply down here with the two around the one guardian cocks as well. So multiple kind of guardians going on here. Now, the other interesting aspect is that you have the etheric type swirls coming out this side. And I keep making mention of the etheric type swirls in architecture. So the guardian sort of spirit set up right here. Reference to the fish in this case within here. Again, this kind of Ashtar type star configuration in here. Crabs once again. Reference to a man beating, maybe a man with a serpent right there. So just having a look within this, very interesting. The museum is right through here, the museum, Vietnamese Museum of Ethnology. Now, we have some more Greek-esque type architecture here, and among other things, in front of this hotel here, what would be with the maidens, reference to the arts, you have the male and female representation up here, and the classic, the two smaller doorways, the triptych here, the triptych of doorways. And with the sort of magic circle on the ground here with the lotus type petals, and also within here the cherubim with the chains around that central tree, the central pillar in the center. And you can see the tree configuration there, not unlike what you would see with the old ritual poles, tree poles in the museum. Corinthian style pillars up here. Just looking at this further, it's a brand new building going in here.